Her classmates attacked her every day, but eventually she came out on top. A lot of people look back at their high school years with great fondness. This is the time of your life when you make lifelong friends, go to school dances, and prepare yourself for adulthood. However, it's not exactly a breeze for everyone. Bullying's a sad reality many kids face, and many want to get high school over and done with to get a fresh start. Desiree Turner was the type of student who enjoyed high school and liked going to class every single day. She was on good terms with everyone in her class, so it came as a shock that something of this sort happened to her. Desiree was a normal high school student. The 17-year-old girl prepared for the SATs and tried her best to get the best possible marks. She wanted to attend a top college, so she needed to get high marks to accomplish her dreams. Her group of friends had been supportive of her about this, and they often talked about what life would be like when they were done with high school. The world was their oyster. It was a tight-knit community, and the entire town would come together to attend pep rallies during big sporting events. Team spirit was an integral part of the school. The mascot wandered all over the campus and took photos with everyone there. The school they went to is called Green Canyon High School, located in Utah. She spent 4 years there before she was set to go to college. She lived in the small town of North Logan, where nearly all the students knew each other one way or the other. Growing up can be challenging for many children. It's important to have parents who will support you and give you a loving environment. Desiree was lucky enough to have parents who loved her a lot. When she needed advice or a hug, her dad and mom would always be there. North Logan was a nice place to raise children in, so not once did anyone suspect that something this unfortunate would happen to a girl like Desiree. She never imagined her peers could act so cruelly. It was a good thing her parents didn't ever leave her side after the incident. She needed them now more than ever. It started out like any other day. Desiree just got out of school and was on her way home. She spent a few hours studying with her friends and was walking home to get dinner with her family. While walking, she soon spotted shadows right behind her. All of a sudden, they materialized into the form of two guys she knew from school. Jason Decker and Colter Peterson had been waiting for her all this time. She had something they wanted. No one had any idea that something like this would ever happen in a quiet town. Worse, they never thought these boys capable of such cruelty. All of a sudden, the pair went up to Desiree. They wanted money and believed that she was going to be an easy target. Desiree had been walking on her own and dusk was approaching at the time. The moment they went after her, she tried her best to escape, but they managed to catch up to her and pushed her onto the pavement. There was a brief battle, but Desiree couldn't get away. That's when things got really heated. One of the boys took out a weapon, which made the encounter a lot nastier right away. In seconds, there was a loud bang that broke the silence. Darkness soon turned into something that looked like a hospital room. Desiree was knocked out for a long time. She was understandably confused when she regained consciousness. Exactly what happened to her? As she gazed down, she noticed tubes attached to her arms in an IV bag. She tried to remember what happened that day, but couldn't recall what led to the hospital. It must have been scary for her. She woke up in a hospital room, but had no idea why. She tried to move her lips and then called for assistance. It then dawned on her she was suffering from paralysis. Anything below her waist didn't have any feeling. At that moment, a nurse entered the room and asked for the doctor. Desiree became crying as she was understandably scared and panicking. It turned out the loud gunshot noise came from the gun the boys shot at her. They shot her in the head, robbed her, and planned to leave her for dead. What kind of humans would do such a horrific thing? It was a good thing a random Good Samaritan saw her and contacted emergency services. However, this only happened 8 hours after the incident. Would she make it through? Although it was a horrific act of violence and her chances were small, Desiree somehow pulled through. Not many people would have survived such an attack, but Desiree's one strong girl and she made it. It was almost a miracle that she even survived. Of course, her parents were glad to hear that Desiree was still alive. However, it meant that they had to deal with a completely new set of problems. Her body started to heal and so did her brain, but she still needed to undergo a number of physiotherapies if she wanted to regain control of her legs. She also had to see a speech therapist to learn how to talk again. While she was in the hospital, the authorities started to look for the suspects involved. Colter and Jason had a reputation at school for discussing firearms and planning to use them in a school shooting. The attack on poor Desiree showed the cops that they had to be locked up to prevent any more untoward incidents. They were both apprehended as soon as the police obtained a warrant. There was no way Colter and Jason could plead not guilty because of Desiree's testimony and CCTV footage. On the day of the trial, the two young men announced they were pleading guilty. Jason and Colter also needed to listen to Desiree as she gave her account of the incident on that terrible day. The judge ended up giving the two teens 15 years to life in prison for the assault on their schoolmate. Yes, the two young men would not be roaming freely soon. No doubt it was a very traumatic event for Desiree. She was not simply going to let what happened to her define the rest of her life. She saw them in court and said that what they did to her was horrible. For 3 years, she saw them in the hallways and even took classes with them. It was hard for her to understand what would possess anyone to do such a thing. We can understand why the young woman hated them. The good news was that she was alive and free. She plans to live her life to the fullest. She feels grateful that she made it through and hopes to somehow, someday, put this all behind her. Sadly, she suffered permanent brain damage from the gunshot wound. Many things had to change for Desiree, and she'll forever have ongoing medical issues because of it. She had to have a lot of intense surgeries to improve her condition. The left side of her body has suffered a lot, and she gets debilitating migraines without warning at all. However, she worked hard to have a normal life despite everything that's happened to her. Upon learning about what happened, the people in town had some thoughts about the terrible incident. The entire community saw that life was going to be hard for Desiree. She dreamed of attending college in the fall, but now she had to put the plan on hold. Local businesses teamed up to send the family various things that they could use for her recovery. One business even sent a bicycle in the hopes that it would give Desiree independence when she felt well enough to take it for a ride. However, she needed something else aside from this. In high school, prom and the homecoming dance are part of the rites of passage. These are two events in teenagers' life that let them dress up in gorgeous dresses and dance the night away with their friends. This is their chance to feel like princes and princesses for a night. Desiree wanted to have a Cinderella moment of her own and the chance to be a normal teenager again. She didn't know if she'd get the opportunity to do so now that she was suffering from limited mobility. A lot of young girls dream about the day their name would be called during the announcement of the homecoming queen. The student who gets crowned would stand up on stage, wear the crown, and wave at the rest of the student body. It would be a magical experience, and Desiree also hoped she could make this dream a reality, but it didn't seem likely after what she went through. All she could do was dream. By then, the entire town had already heard of what happened to poor Desiree. The four Skirt classmates also knew Coulter and Jason, so the whole ordeal didn't remain a secret. They wanted to do something nice for their classmate. Her closest friends knew all about her dream to become the homecoming queen, so they planned to make her dream come true. They campaigned on behalf of her. Everyone in the school was happy to have Desiree become their homecoming queen. When her name was announced on the football field, all the people there started to cheer. She still required help with walking, and her dad came to her aid. Desiree placed her hand on his arm as he helped her walk over to the homecoming king. Without a doubt, she felt grateful for that moment. She wanted to let everyone in the school know this, so she chose to do something special for her supporters. She hoped that all girls would also get a Cinderella moment of their own since it made her so happy. She had to give a speech in front of the other students and parents. After taking a deep breath, she started to tell everyone how grateful she was. It must have been unnerving to do such a thing in front of an entire stadium, but public speaking wasn't a problem for her after everything she went through. There was another surprise lying in wait for her, however. Her story succeeded in touching the hearts of people across the state. Violence like this wasn't unheard of, but people were shocked it was carried out by high school students. Everyone wanted to hear about her story of survival and recovery. Desiree was happy to oblige this request and talked about her story with anyone who wanted to know more about it. She was a survivor and hoped that her words would inspire others who wanted to reclaim their lives after traumatic events. Desiree only had one more year before she could graduate, so she had a ton of schoolwork to catch up on. It was fine, however, since she found a new calling in life. She's a member of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. The young woman's heavily involved in the community. She's realized that going to college this soon was not for her. Instead, she has her calling in the missions her church offers. What else is she doing today? Desiree had always been interested in animals. There was a time when she was thinking of training to become a veterinarian, but this doesn't seem viable for her after her brain trauma she suffered. It doesn't mean that she would never get to work with animals, however. The church mission still allowed her to work with animals, which is ideal. The only thing she needs to do now is finish school. Her life is only beginning. She's now doing her best to finish high school and plans to get more involved with the church after that. Her parents often see her studying and reading about different animals. We're very glad to hear Desiree has stayed strong despite all the challenges life has thrown at her. She might have had to relearn everything, but she didn't let this stop her from meeting her goals. Truly, it is inspiring to hear how someone so young managed to beat the odds. She survived a terrible incident and took her life back. We sure hope that she finds a mission that will let her fully recover from the incident and work with animals at the same time. Her story shows us that you can overcome any challenge as long as you stay strong and work hard. We can tell that she will get far in life.